Have you run out of ammunition?
No, I have not.
So what do you see then in your business? Where did Make America Get It Wrong?
With regards to the comments you just made on the packaging sector, I think that there's been significant price increases over the course of the last 12 to 18 months. I think there's worry that those price increases are coming to an end. Whether that actually happens or not is going to be based on, you know, supply-demand balance as well as what's happening with raw material inputs.
We've heard a lot about pricing power, lack of pricing power. Mm-hmm. Have you had pricing power because of the rapid increase in things like Amazon shipments?
Certainly fulfillment, which is where we would categorize those kinds of shipments. The demand for those products has continued to increase. But ultimately, it comes down to, I think, more than just that. Certainly, there's exports going out of the marketplace, as well as just general economic strength for packaging in general.
Have your clients like a Walmart, Amazon, Starbucks seen any, have you seen any demand fall off due to DC? Potential trade wars, concerns, CEO confidence?
So in our business, most of what we do is domestic. About 93% of our business is in the United States. You know, we do support some of those customers, but we cut across broad sectors, both in the manufacturing as well as in the service sector. And so we haven't seen a significant drop off in any of those. In fact, our demand growth has been fairly robust since about this time last year.
So your profitability is a function not just of the revenues coming in, but the costs going out.
Absolutely.
And what are the challenges you and costs, particularly as we look at the employment market? Are you having to pay higher wages?
Yeah, well, wages is a big concern for us, but it's not the entire picture. We need to look at total compensation for our employees. About 65% of our total cost structure is based on people costs. And although wages are modestly going up, I think they're up just over 2% year over year, the challenge is much greater than that. Health and welfare benefits, in our case, have gone up more than 10% just in 2018. And so it's about the total compensation for employees, not just wages.
Yeah, I was going to say, so if you're faced the decision, do you hire someone new, do you hire someone who's less qualified and train them up, or do you pay someone more, or do you increase productivity? Like, what's your strategy?
You can never look at any one, depending on the talent that you're trying to hire and for what types of jobs. And so we do try to look at it in a more balanced approach. We recognize that we have to do more of our own internal training because we're not able to get the talent that we need in all of the roles that we need. And so supporting training programs, offering a balanced approach in the total comp segment is really important, a combination of both wages, benefits, as well as other benefits beyond just health care, but other benefits as well to attract talent.
Your taxes are going down. What are you going to do with that money?
Well, actually, because of the nature of our transaction, we're a brand new company. Even though we're a Fortune 500 company, we've only been in existence less than 4 years. And we've been spending a lot of money to integrate our companies because it was a result of a spin, a merge, and an IPO. And so to that point, we've had net income losses as we've invested in building a foundation for the future of the company. And so we don't have those benefits today, but we do would expect to have them in the future. And our approach on whenever we have cash in the business is to have a balanced approach of paying down debt, investing in the future of the company, and providing value to our shareholders.
I just want to round it out with sort of what potential risk in your company, and that's trucking. What kind of backlog and bottlenecks are you seeing in the country? Is it demand or supply?
The trucking industry has been really challenged for many reasons. First of all, there is a huge shortage of drivers across North America. And so that's putting pressure. That's a result of just having the talent and the people that want to go into the industry. There's been increased demand for trucking as a result of a stronger economy, as a shift to e-commerce, as well as there's been a reduction in capacity in the rail systems, and that's all put pressure and strain on the trucking industry. We're sheltered somewhat in that we do 85% of our own transportation, but we still have some exposure with third-party freight.